All right, Cyrus says podcast starts with my inevitable enthusiasm, Josh Janoon, which nobody else shares. We have Rohan Joshi, one of the best in the business, on the other line. He'll join us in 30 seconds. But first, I want to talk about the game yesterday. What a match! What a super performance against a run of play. Once we lost punt, we thought it was over and they would get less than 200 to chase and blah, blah, blah. But in the end, we slaughtered them. I mean, the whole second half of the match was India just. You could see the shift. The shift was fabulous. The psychological damage that we've done to a team which, albeit, has only one batsman and 10 fielders, basically. But yet, you can't take it away. What a fabulous victory with 7-8 overs to spare. Well done. And I would like to say this as we start the podcast. So, all those people at Wankhede Stadium in the 80s and 90s who abused Ravi Shastri for no reason, only because he was a good-looking guy and seemed a little aloof from the normal person, they would just attack him and say, "Ravi Shastri, Murdabad." I stand here today and ask you all to raise your fist and say, "Ravi Shastri, Zindabad." Well done, Ravi. And I hope to meet you soon. He's a personal friend. We're very close. I don't want to name drop and show off, but I know them all. All of them are personal friends, all on first name basis, some on pet name basis. So is Rohan Joshi, who's joining us now on the podcast. Rohan, welcome to that's too much, I suppose. It's not like the Oprah Winfrey show. So I'll just say hi. I think we'll end there.
Ravi Shastri
Ravi Shastri Zindabad. Are you
Zindabad. Ravi
kidding? Oh,
Shastri Zindabad.
Is that going to be the
I
whole
do enjoy
podcast?
cricket. I do enjoy cricket, and I feel like yesterday was the sort of fifth day where even if you're not a cricket lover, like I was watching with a bunch of people who don't usually follow, but there was that point around that seven
So you're
wicket
talking about
mark, like when the
like a
last 10.
carpenter, a guy who's fixing the computer, that kind of thing.
Everyone, everyone. Yeah, because you know, I mean, I don't have any real friends.
I
So,
know
like, you know,
those are
we
the
were
best
around, I
people
was
to
like,
hang out
come.
with. I think it's very
Exactly.
Indian. It bonds the Indian masses together when you know seven people who know each other
Absolutely.
scream for the same cricketer
But you
with
know,
different
that's, and
accents.
everybody knows, right? Exactly. Like, just where that one thing binds you, and there are people who no real interest in it. But there was that point where it was like the last sort of 15 overs of the day, and like music went off, everything went off. People are just like, okay, we need to watch this game. And yeah, what a great, great win.
And for those who want to kill test cricket, you know, I mean, 5 days, but during the lockdown, we had the time. It
Oh,
all worked out.
yeah.
I mean, up and down, twist and
I
turn,
think
it's beautiful.
overall, like the last decade has made a very good case, no, for like Test cricket's existence. Like
And
very,
especially
very, very
India.
result oriented.
In India, we win in 2 days, so it's not a test match. But outside India, it's like,
Exactly.
you know, I mean, look, the Brisbane
We
win
take
two
the whole
back-to-back.
5 days. We like we earn the whole
We take the whole
paycheck
five
and we
days.
come.
I'm saying if you end a game with seven, eight overs to spare, and any result was possible with the bad light, et cetera, nobody asked for more. And we win. So from a jingoistic point of view, because jingoism is the name of the game, if you want to survive India in the 2020s, you must say,
You are
Jai,
correct.
Nothing. Nothing. We must say nothing, Rohan.
We
Never
must
forget
move on
that.
respectfully. We must
Let's
move on
respectfully move on.
respectfully.
Let's speak
That's all
in
we
the
must
Queen's
do.
English. That keeps you safe. They don't understand what you're saying. Just, you know. Put on
Queen, not
accent,
my queen,
Murda.
not my queen, guys. Just saying, not
She's
my
my
queen,
queen.
not
She's
my
my
queen.
queen.
Not my
She's
queen.
my
Not my queen. Not my queen.
She's my
My
queen.
queen.
She's my queen. Of course, we have a few queens in the business as well, but not that that's a bad thing. Rohan, you may not remember this because of the early onset of Alzheimer's and the other issues you've had, but you were on the show before. So we've
Yes.
exhausted
Yes.
all your topics of your early years. I do
It's
remember
done.
the Chennai sojourn was the most interesting and funny part for me. And I would love to revisit it, but I've been told never do that because you'll upset everybody. We do have a second thing to talk to you about, which is
Okay.
the whole lockdown, Rohan Joshi. So I thought,
Yes.
let's look at it that way because you had to reinvent yourself, as everybody has, and figure out how to get work, how to pay bills. I can see that even though you're not wearing pants, you are wearing the track top, which is a symbol of
Exactly,
either
right?
Sicilian mafia and
As
the
long
Portuguese.
as you're warm, as long as you're warm, like
Yeah,
yeah, going for this like very
please don't
Albanian
unzip.
like mafia vibe, like really going
Yeah,
for it,
but do not
like
unzip, okay? As low as this show is, we have to
saving
draw
it
the
for the
line
second half,
somewhere.
saving it for the second half, saving it for the
There you
second half.
go. So here's my point. We'll look at the whole lockdown thing, and then we come to the fact that you've got this show called Crypto Bhai on IVM, because obviously you want to just basically push that show since it's our show and nepotism
Of
and
course,
partisanship is
nepotism
important.
is
It's there in the
bestism.
Indian Constitution, you know, page 17, paragraph 2F clearly states, please help your friends and relatives.
Exactly.
So
And
you tell us.
I told you not to write it there in pencil, but you wrote it anyway, and now it's there. It's fine.
They wanted someone to
Done.
speak the Queen's English once again, the one that you don't like, but I
Arre,
do. And I
now
had to do
it's
my
fine.
bit, yeah. There you go. So going back to 2020-21, revisiting the glory years. Okay, let's go back a little before that. So what was happening? You had a lot of these one-man shows. You had a show on Amazon. You did very well.
Full on. Like 2019 was like it's almost like I knew the lockdown was coming, I think. Like I was all over the country. I was just traveling, doing show here, doing show there, doing here, because the show that eventually went on Amazon was
A
like took
collection
a year
of.
of touring to do. It took a year of touring to do. And then I did that show, that finished. And then suddenly this lockdown comes. So in a way, I was a little bit done traveling. But there was somewhere around like month, like I remember September last year, there was this point where I'm just like, I think I'm going crazy. Like, I thought I loved staying at home, but I think even I don't love staying at home this much.
Like, it's the marginal utility of the product, Ron, if I can interrupt. I've been telling people the same problem. It's like sex or butter chicken or anything else that you like. You can't do it too much.
True, because of age.
But yeah, so people have to understand. Didn't a lot of people say, wow, I've got a break after 20 years. Forget us. I'm talking about people in businesses or whatever, where they go 9 to 7 every day for 20 years. That redundancy that they feel about the same business.
Yeah.
So then they got that break for 3-4 months. By the fifth month, that same Mr. Mehta is screaming and shouting, boss, I want to go back to my factory or my, you know, corporate job.
Yeah.
Anything for my boring life back. Yeah. So where is
that? I mean, just 5 or 6 people just trapped in a house. Again, doesn't matter how much you love your family. And let's face it, not everybody loves their family.
Envelope on that one. Didn't he, the immortal line, loving your family? It's all about loving your family.
Yeah, it's all about loving your family. Yeah, loving your parents, loving your family. Loving your parents. Yes.
No, loving your family. It's all about loving your family.
Oh, family only it was, or what? Or the family?
It's family dynamics. The whole plot just revolves around this chacha and that chachi and this mama.
Everyone. Everyone is that. So I have a question for you. How did you, because I know you and I know that, you're not a huge fan of technology. So
there's satire and there's biting satire. I place that in biting satire. Yeah.
I'm just saying you're not a fan, right? You're not a fan is what I'm saying. And then, so how has 2021 been for you?
Yeah, so I'm not a fan. I'm the antithesis of technology. Right now, I was in the club where your sister used to come, but for some reason has stopped coming. And some idiots were asking me to vote for them as usual. And then they were trying to show me the website where you have to go to vote and how you vote and whatever. And I couldn't do a thing, Rohan. And they all looked at each other because two of them were much younger, two of them were older. So I'm right in the middle. You can't do the ageism game. And the whole thing was, I'll tell you the exact problem then, because I think your show also will explain that to people like me. So we had to get onto the thing, the link, and then the thing would come on your SMS, right? The PIN number for which you have to then add that on, and then you get open it and enter it, and then you can vote. But the problem is I couldn't go back to the page after getting the message. And
No.
So I wasn't able to vote.
You were trapped in pin hell. You were trapped in pin hell. You were trapped in pin code hell.
I agitated out there and I started sweating and all because, I'm trying to do it. And the guy said, go back to the page. But I'm like, it's not going. I don't know how to. I press the button, goes back to WhatsApp. And in the middle, there's a lot of porn shit that keeps coming up on Chrome. I don't know, somebody...
Distracted. What you're saying is you got distracted.
Not even distracted. It's just that they can see my history because they're trying all these things, trying buttons and all that. And Lobster Tube is coming up and this is coming up. In between there's zealots against Christianity and Islam and all that. So there's nothing good in my phone, It's a really scary place to be. There's either sex or anti-religious stuff and, I don't get into it.
I'm just imagining you standing at the club. Look, isn't there just a booth I can go to with my Aadhaar and just get this over with?
Can I just write a letter saying I support so-and-so like the old days? I remember election in school, right at the end when we had these. I don't know if they still do that stuff. You elect the monitor with this thing, right? So I remember So we used to write the note. This is the best electoral process. You write it in front of everyone. There's nobody. 30 kids. They write the name. You put it in a basket. That's it. There's no double checking. Story. Nothing. Wow. What a process. Really want to go back to those days. Anyway, now you've distracted me with my own weakness and made me feel pain and depression. So let's go back to you. I just want to know. So you're doing all these tours. You're doing all this stuff. You've got this Amazon thing on your up your sleeve, which comes out of doing all that. So that's 50% of what you do is just snatched away, right? Because you're a very well-known comedian and touring and the money that comes with that and what you do with that experience and you put it into the Amazon.
Absolutely.
So that's robbed from you. And let's face it, doing the Zoom calls and all is not quite the same thing.
So 2020 anyway was not supposed to be a heavy touring year. I was going to do not a lot of stand-up because I wanted to do a bunch of writing in 2020. But what the main thing, to touch upon what you said is the snatched away, right? In terms of today you do comedy, I do comedy, we do all of that stuff. Everything we talk about is based on relatability, right? We all went somewhere and we had a common experience and here's what's funny about that experience. Now in a year and a half where everybody has been trapped at home, what are we going to talk about? What are we talking about? And we had either the exact same experience or such vastly different and depressing experiences, Rohan, for so many
look
people.
Look at my, I can't even copy your stuff because I don't know how to download. I don't know how to open the page.
Nothing.
I don't know how to refresh the page. So, I can't even do what a lot of people do.
I'll send you printouts. I'll send you printouts.
I'll come and watch your show and write down the jokes.
I'm imagining you with a papyrus scroll now for some reason.
Something like that, exactly that. You know, wearing one of those monk outfits.
It was an internet, but it was also fun in a way, just sort of seeing like people start these new formats, like Zoom shows. They're not exactly like stand-up shows, right? In the sense, because now that you have video, you can do a bunch of different things. You can do a bunch of different times.
I only get 2 laughs a year in any case. But when I did the first Zoom show where they said, do 20 minutes like a monologue and you're talking, nobody's answering you. And
it's damn weird.
Used to, someone like me with less material, I spend the whole time talking to the audience. So you know, there's no audience. There's no one like, you know, to interface with.
Yeah.
And you don't get any timing. So you're just running. And anyway, I talk too fast. So
no, you're right. You're absolutely right. Like all timing is built off that natural response of the audience. And here you have to build in one extra half second pause for the delay of the internet and all of that. So you have no idea what's happening.
And Ron, I'm sure you agree with me. Nothing is worse than an awkward pause which has no sound. It's better they boo you, man. Don't like your joke.
They
take you on. That's fine. But when it's silent, it's like somebody dies.
The thing is, like, when it's like, I think with a comic, especially or a speaker, what happens is, like you said, boos in this thing, it's a reaction. When there's silence, then you feel obligated to fill the silence with more shit. And that's where you really dig your own grave.
God. Oh, that's hilarious when that happens. When you try to talk more to get out of it.
You know, and then you're just digging deeper and you're just going lower and lower.
But that's why you need the crowd. The crowd can save you at any point from anything. But without a crowd, so what do you do?
Nothing.
You just go faster with your stupid material. Oh, it's horrible.
So which is why also what has been fun to do is to do shows with other people. Because if you're doing shows with multiple people on the same panel, then at least you guys are giving some feedback to each other or laughing at each other's
stuff.
This
is fine. Which is why I feel like a lot of it. If you have even one person to interact with, you're okay because there's some rhythm and whatever. And
exactly.
You know, self-respecting person should watch this podcast, but still, at least you don't feel that bad at the end of it. I mean, you
exactly. Self-respecting people should only participate in this podcast.
Don't you have someone to scratch your back? I mean, after all these years in the business, what's going on?
Arey, no, man. I'm a humble, self-made man. Like, it's just
really?
I prefer
masturbating.
You know?
The group's cause social distancing. You made your point.
Got to connect. Got to connect with yourself sometimes. Like,
fair enough. And avoid the pandemic. By the way, are you double vaccinated?
I am single vaccinated because I also got a very, very mild brush with COVID a couple of a month or so ago. Super mild, but which I have to wait for my second dose. I feel like
COVID after the first dose.
But extremely mild, like in the sense that
vaccine
no
failed.
Symptom.
No, I have to put this down. This is ridiculous. I have to call up the government. This is nonsense. You're known to be left leaning, so possibly they give you a smaller dose. Something's going on here.
That's
is it COVID or
you?
COVID?
If you call the government and say Cyrus calling, they'll think it's Mr. Poonawala only. You know, anyway.
Yeah, they won't take the call.
You don't have to. Yeah, you just
Hey, Magya, no. Promise karo, kuch bhi promise karo, ho jayega. Yeah, that's true. But it's a name they know now, one way or the other. Everybody
exactly, one way or another. Cyrus ka call gets answered, one way or another.
But unfortunately, once again, not definitely, you know, the right contact to have at the moment, poor guy. From what I gather. Let's get back to the life and times of Rohan Joshi. So, I want to get into crypto as well. And the show on YouTube was when? That was during this.
What show on YouTube?
Your YouTube show, which is 30 questions.
30 questions. 30 questions is something that I do on and off. I don't have, I have to give it to you for having this discipline to just keep doing this podcast, this thing. So 30 questions is a show that exists. I cannot tell you in what format it exists. I cannot tell you what day of the week, every this thing it comes. 30 questions is like a cat. It just aa jata hai kabhi kabhi. Aur phir chala jata hai kabhi kabhi. That's 30 questions.
Is that your take on helping Arnab understand that it's a two-way medium? Because he does 30 answers, which all come from
exactly him, so, 30 answers for questions nobody asked.
Nobody's asked. Yeah, you figure them out later. That's very intelligent. Imagine you give the answer first. It's like buying the video, and the TV comes many years later. Okay,
exactly.
80s and 90s. Please bear with me.
Children watching today, a videotape was a thing that went in making physical sounds.
Can you imagine? There's a generation who's never seen a telephone. What do you call it? A landline
rotary
telephone,
phone.
The old fashioned, the way we used to have. Yeah.
The rotary one. The one that you could murder people with.
But that was, as an actor, I'm sure you've used it. Now that's a prop. You can really use you know?
It's got gravitas. It's got full gravitas.
Yeah, much more character. Look at this. This is crap.
Like, you remember in those old movies, right? 90% of those suspense scenes started with, there were those phones with those gold handles and those white things. And they'd be ringing. And then one guy in a bathrobe would answer it. Hello.
You're spot on, and the whole shot would be 5 minutes because their phone
would
be a
just on that
shot.
Phone that's ringing.
Like, you're so dumb, we don't know it's ringing up in 9 rings.
Exactly.
Then they close up on the guy's face, the pickup, the turn,
the bathrobe.
The dialogue, DK Dasgupta ka phone hai sahab. You know, they'll be always have a name like DK Dasgupta or DK Bhai.
Always, Shahar ke jaane maane industrialist.
Cinema was at its zenith and we didn't even know it. We were laughing and making fun. Really.
The best times are past us.
Sad. We can't get them back, folks. This is not telling you to do drugs, but if you take an extra Crocin, we won't blame you. Let's go back to 30 questions from the online users. Now, I just want to figure this. So you did this before the pandemic, because this sounds like a spot on show to do during the pandemic.
No, this is during the pandemic. During the pandemic, I wanted to do a show where I just wanted to talk to people exactly like this sort of format where it's very like unmediated, just chatting, hanging out.
Yeah.
And also what I want to do with 30 questions is I just want to get the audience in on it also. So it's a YouTube stream. And the way it works is that whoever's on the stream can leave as long after they've answered 30 questions, combination of questions I ask and whatever the audience asks. And it just ends up becoming a really fun conversation.
So the lesson to be learned for all of us is if it's not interactive, it's not going to work for long on this medium. But what is Ashish Shakya's role, or is this wrongly given to me?
No. Ashish, he's a part of that. He's my co-host on 30 Questions. And like
more?
We hang out and we talk to people. Who gets paid more? The guy who sold me my computer to do the show. He's the only person who has been paid in this endeavor.
Guru Simran Khamba. Okay, got it. So give me 3 dirty habits of Ashish Shakya.
3 dirty habits. No, Ashish is very sweet, hygienic. You've known Ashish Shakya as long as I've known Ashish Shakya. Let's not forget that. 3 dirtiest habits of Ashish Shakya is that he's impossible to wake up in the morning. He is impossible to get to go to sleep early at night. Do I have a third dirty habit of Ashish Shakya? Ashish Shakya eats more Chinese food than any human being I know. That's
Direct descendant of the Saka clan of the Buddha. So you know
this is true. Yeah.
Spiritual man. Don't judge by the comedy. True. The comedy is spiritual when you think about it.
This is true.
I'll tell you one thing. When he was with CNN, IBN, and rightly so, he spent most of the time in the accounts department fighting over money. I've never seen
a guy fight. Which is 90% of your job as a freelancer.
Yeah, I suppose so, yeah. But he's always there complaining. Like I said, rightly so. He probably still hasn't got paid. Whatever pittance they were paying us then, which continues with us, but he's doing better. Cool. So let's move to Crypto Bhai, which is not called Crypto Bhai.
Yes.
A crypto show on IBM.
It's a show about crypto. Yes.
Yeah. I shouldn't make fun. We're all supporters of cryptocurrency. I'm sure, Rohan, you've been paid in that for the last 12 months and you're milking it.
Of course.
Go ahead.
Of course.
What is this show all about? And how can an idiot like me understand it?
So exactly that. You've answered the question. The show is literally, if you feel like you're an idiot about cryptocurrency, you start from episode 1. Literally, the first question on the show is, what is a cryptocurrency? What does this crypto, like I know what currency means, even though as a freelancer, you don't always get it. I know what currency means. What is this crypto thing? And we start from there. And every time a question comes up, no matter how stupid, we go for it. And the entire point is that I'm learning. So every episode, genuinely, at the end of every episode, I have learned like a good 45 minutes more about crypto than I knew before the previous episode. And the thing is, like, do you, this ever happen to you when you read like these Economic Times shit, all these brown color papers? They just assume that like you know a lot of fancy words. Like the first word in the headline will only be like the DMAT of the EBITDA of the like bar graph says that you should sell on 45.
I don't follow that trap because I'm always looking for naked pictures. You know, for me, it's from childhood. Whatever it is, it's naked picture. So if I don't see the naked picture,
like,
I don't
South Bombay mein kya alag? Kya South Bombay mein kya alag?
South Bombay ka hai? Like, my friend, don't betray your people.
Main abhi Santa Cruz ka hai. Main said, I'm betraying. This is, you know, this is a...
You are born in South Bombay. You cannot leave that behind.
To all viewers who are saying the reason Cyrus Docha is looking for these pictures in the paper is because all people of the 80s and 90s were corrupted by a thing in the midday called the midday mate. No,
yes.
In the midday,
Friday was a
thing called the midday mate.
I used to skip Friday, yeah.
Which is great, but in the sense that midday mate for no reason, in the middle of news, they were just like, here is a picture of a scantily clad woman or a Cyrus said man. And you just sort of looked at it and went, okay, ab dekhte cricket mein kya hua. So that is why Cyrus still today is looking for naked pictures in his newspaper.
Can I just go back to the Tebbit test to prove why you're a South Mumbaiker for life? Then the Tebbit test in the 70s, which came up in English politician, is whether why the Indians, the Pakistanis, the West Indians would cheer for their own team. And that's like anti-national, because now they're Brits. So the same thing is that although you were in South Bombay first and you've gone to Santa Cruz, your heart will always be in South Mumbai and you'll cheer for us. You can't stop that because emotionally that tie is there. So you're like a Desi abroad.
See, As far as I'll be honest with you, Cyrus. Don't I don't lie know where my heart. Rohan Joshi. No. Cyrus, I think you are lying to yourself. It is not about whether my heart is in South Bombay right now or not. The question is, will my heart transplant eventually be at Breach Candy Hospital? Then you can truly say, I am a South Bombay.
That depends on this Amazon Prime show and the crypto show, bro. That's really not in my hands.
That's true.
I wish to help
That's
you.
True.
You know,
That's
but
true.
Remember, there are cheaper hospitals all over which guarantee you worse results, but peace of mind at the end of the day because you paid less. That's what I believe.
This is true.
It's all linked, after all. If you pay too much, anxiety, stress, heart attack, it's all coming in the same direction. Okay,
this is all
so
true.
Sorry. So crypto. So what makes you the bop of crypto? But you have a huge interest in this, or because you read
I have an interest.
Times.
I have a spectacular interest in it, like I have for the last couple of years, but I've always felt like I don't understand it. And everybody I talk to feels like they're always like five steps ahead of me. So I'm like, okay, if all you guys are five steps ahead of me, I'm just going to talk to all of those people and try to cover those five steps in this show. Because I'm like, chal, if I'm putting little like money into it or if I'm interested into it, I figure I should know what I'm doing. At least something in my life, I should know what I'm doing. Not happen with comedy, not happening like this. Let me have a basic idea of what I'm doing. So yeah, everything about cryptocurrency, I think so, cryptocurrency legal in India. Like,
has someone guided you, or that's the wrong word, guided?
Oh yeah, we have a very competent producer. We have very competent researchers on this show. I feel like you may have met our producer. I get the feeling. We share
a 17-year-old guy called Sinuri.
That sounds accurate. Yeah.
He's the one who's advising you.
Yeah, 100%.
The man is wanted by the police in all four corners of the globe.
That's exactly who you want to take advice from. A man who's wanted by the police in all corners of the globe and somehow still free. Who better to take advice from? It's Nirav Modi doesn't take my calls anymore. So now I have to make do with him.
He can if you call collect.
fair.
Rohan, let's get back to this crypto thing for a second. Well, honestly, this is a personal question. So you invest in crypto, obviously? I mean, it wouldn't be one-sided, would it? So
yes.
What would be the right percentage? Is there a right percentage? Like how we talk about equity and...
So right now, especially because it's a sort of... this is entirely my personal perspective on it is... my logic is put in money where today, if for any reason you lost it, you'd be like, you know what? One holiday is gone or one something. Don't put in any money where you're like,
two holidays are gone anyway, thanks to the pandemic. Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry in that case. Then maybe crypto is not for you. I recommend you buy ITC.
I do have ITC. So you're saying, but that's a subjective thing, nah? Because my holiday may cost 5 lakhs. My friend Kunal is 10 lakhs.
Start with that. Because the thing is, sure, but I'm saying that's what I'm saying. Start with an amount which you'd feel comfortable, say, losing as the cost of education.
So it's a punt.
Like, as
then.
Opposed to Mera Barbar. It's not a punt so much as you're paying to learn, if that makes sense. You put in a little money,
but
you see
what
the market does.
What you're saying is a good chance that this money is going to disappear. I thought
no, there's not a good chance that this money is going to disappear. There's a good chance that money is going to disappear if you like sort of wade in like guns blazing without the correct information, because it is a wildly speculative market. It is a bit like the Wild West. It is a bit like the gold rush. For every one person who's telling you that there's gold on their plot, there are 10 who do not have any gold to back like what they've got. So a lot of it is this is a market where like Elon Musk tweets one thing and then the price of an entire asset just sort of zigzags over the next couple of days. So it's just, you don't want to fall into those traps. And a lot of investing in this is just like learning to avoid that hype.
Okay, so here's the second personal question. Would you have, as Rohan Joshi, would you have made money so far? Would you say
yes,
you made money?
I would say yes, I would. I would. Yes, yes,
alone.
Yes. If literally so today, if
like
I were to liquidate...
a percentile figure like, on 100
okay, without like, I don't want to give an exact this thing, but at least as a sort of speculative
Notional
asset class,
guide
it's outperformed.
It
so like what, 20%? Like...
Okay, 20%. Yeah. So
I'm talking about under a year. Like I'm talking in under a year.
Oh, that's not bad at all. So you have 20% gain in 12 months or less.
Mm-hmm.
On so that if you had taken a punt and put 90% of all your money in it, you'd be 20% up. Like seriously.
Yeah.
Why didn't
but
you
in the sense,
yourself,
it's also
Rohan?
Because I'll tell you one thing. It is terrifying. All right, it is not at all like the stock market. It's like you could go to bed.
Elon Musk is one tweet and it crashed.
No, but that's what I'm saying. You go to bed and the thing that you invested in is like flying, and then you wake up the next morning and it's crashing and burning on the ground. And then you go to bed again, and then something else has happened. So there's a lot of volatility. So you're not going to just be like, oh, just because I'm doing well today, I'm going to suddenly put in more, because things can change quick. So you've got to, unlike the stock market, one, you really have the patience to like monitor on a day-to-day basis, because this market moves at that pace.
Is there a way to average? Do you take an average? Like 3 months, 6 months?
You can absolutely. So that's obviously the easiest way to invest, right? Where you put in like a small amount and you go like every week, no matter what this thing is, I back this asset and I'll just keep putting that. Eventually on the solid ones, I feel like on things like Bitcoin, Ethereum, etc., you will end net up. Like, so.
Has the Indian government invested in crypto?
I don't know if the Indian government is invested in crypto or not, but I can say, and I have learned this on a show about crypto on IVM podcast, where we had a blockchain lawyer. It's called A Show About Crypto. It's called A Show About Crypto.
Stupidest Cyrus says. Nobody even thought it through. I love it.
So we had this. It's amazing, right?
Yeah.
So we had this blockchain lawyer on, and it's actually really cool because he talked us through the whole thing. And for all, you know, sometimes people are like, is crypto illegal in India, etc.? Turns out it's not. Turns out that like the RBI is
everybody asks. People like me who don't know enough.
Exactly. And the first
of something you don't understand.
So it is not illegal at this point. It has just been classified. My understanding after talking to Varun Sethi, who's a blockchain lawyer, is that at this point it has just been classified as a highly volatile speculative asset, which is the only warning like institutions have put out on it, saying that when you invest in it, treat it that way. And my understanding is even in terms of taxation, etc., you pay capital gains tax on any of your these things. And there is, and in fact, according to Varun, we are a reasonably crypto forward. Our institutions are reasonably crypto forward. He's like, they're not like the top 10 of the world or whatever, but they're not like just entirely bearish on it either. So I feel like it could be fun. It could be interesting.
Okay. So in terms of cigarette smoking being injurious to your health, this is less injurious than a cigarette, because you're only talking about
100%
in the market where you win or lose, depending on how much you, like you said, you put aside a bit so that if you lose, you still survive sort of thing.
So it's not the worst thing
in the world. One more question, then we'll take the break. So, catching on in India? Is it because everybody wants to talk about it, but I'm still scared, for example. A lot of people are conservative people. I
100%.
I wouldn't change in front of other people right till last year when I had to.
Change in front of other people. You grew up in the Bombay Gymkhana dressing room like I did. How dare you? How dare you tell such scurrilous lies on broadcast?
Rohan, they'd pay me.
No.
Those old men would pay me to show me show my legs and all that. I mean, those were different days.
You got paid? You got paid?
I have lovely legs. I'll show you one day. You give me a cryptocurrency tip. Every time you do that, I send you a picture. Okay?
How's done. Done. So, it is definitely catching on. Obviously, the worries with it catching on is that you're going to have some people who are going to go in on hype. So, I feel like education is going to become damn important going forward, because you have people who you see Elon Musk tweet and they suddenly put in a lot of money, and then the next day that money is just gone and they're like, oh my God, this must be a scam. No, it's not a scam. It's just, you need to do a little reading before you decide where you're going to put it. And it is catching on, though. And I feel like a lot of young people are at least looking at it, not just in India, but sort of around the world, even just a sort of this decentralized protocol.
So let's take that example for a second. We're taking too long on this, but last time. So Silvery, our common producer, put some money in, for example. Elon Musk screwed a lot of people up. Okay. It just dumped completely and just plunged. How long did it take to revive? One. And two, is there an algorithm where there will be 3 or 4 bumps a year or something like that, and then you come to the news?
My understanding in as little as 8 months is like the market, and this is off the top of my head, I feel like the market seen 3 cycles in just 8 months. I'm talking full bull run, then back to support levels, then full bull run, then back to, and now it looks like again we're on a bit of a bull run type place. Right. So this is why I say it's scary, right? Which is why they talk about like what in the crypto world they call holding or hodling, HODLING, which is like just the ability to sit on it when things are going crazy, which is to not immediately sell at the top of a bull run, but also wait out the bear market, like in the sense, you get like 4 years worth of stock market, like bull and bear runs in like 8 months.
I get that, but I'm just distracted by the holding, hodling. Is that like a Gurgaon word? Because they couldn't say holding, did that become like hodling?
It's one of those internet Reddit words. Yeah. It's like a Reddit word, which you could describe as the Gurgaon of the internet.
You realize how fair. Uncool is cool. Slowly, uncool takes over everything, you know?
It does, spelling, eventually. It's quite a great story.
Yeah, it's fabulous. I just feel so old. Okay, this is the final question on crypto.
Yes.
Because you answered, I think, for a naive person, I think this is the correct thing that you've said, which is it is similar, I suppose, a little bit to the stock market. There are forces that cause it to go up and down. But three cycles in 8 months is like, you got to have a strong heart. Because let's face it,
you do.
I'm sure this happened to you. When things plunge and whatever money you have in your different assets, of course we don't because we are a poor country, so I'm just talking about other people, that went down a lot and you start feeling depressed, even though it's notional and you know it'll come up at some point, blah, blah.
Yeah.
But here this happens almost, every 2 months, which is a little, you know, there's up and there's down
either,
also.
So like you said, either super strong heart or an investment at this point that's so strong that you don't need a strong heart like, if you lose it. So you start that way and then work your way into the market is what I'd say. And again, this is just as a personal person.
Arwan, it's a life game. You don't get into it to make money and get out. You flip, like you flip a building or house or something. You're not just trying to make a little pie and then F off. You're actually playing this game, trying to get better at it and basically create wealth, which stays in the same
I feel like,
position.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure that there's people who can just like, I'm sure there are people on this market who have also like really flipped assets. So like people like, for example, anybody who had Bitcoin, like say more than 3 years ago at this point has probably bought a house off of that money.
What are you saying?
Yeah, if you had it like say 3 or 4 years ago and where we are today, it's like, it's what you got for pocket change.
Yeah,
it's literally like Tata shares from the old market types. Like it's like that. If you had Apple stock in 1985.
Schnell. Why did you break into German at the right time? So I follow what you're saying. Damn you, man.
So it's exactly that sort of thing. And again, it just comes down to this thing of it depends on your heart, depends on what you're willing to do. And I say this as somebody who is also,
You're the financial romantic, I'm thinking. This is what I call them. You like the idea of a little bit of here and there. In the sense, it's a romance literally of the financial
world. It is. Like for me, this is just a little bit like there is that right, like what you call like khujli pleasure from this, where it's just like part of
you
the fun of
cryptocurrency. My lovely of course, anglicized financial, I like khujli pleasure.
I think this is the point of a show about crypto. We simplify. And so khujli pleasure is that feeling where like a lot of your typical finance institutions are like significantly older dudes, right? And I feel like the fun thing about crypto is for the first time, they feel like they are a little bit like outside going, what the hell is going on here? And what are these like kids doing in this room? And there's something very entertaining about that.
Yeah, I also think what you're saying of gains being 20%, which over a year, I suppose, is an average, which means somebody has made more as well and less.
Oh, 100%. 100%.
Yeah, so which is from a financial point of view, in bad years, I presume these are bad years, pretty bloody good.
Yeah,
I mean, compared to a bank rate in a Western country also, this is...
Oh, 100%. Like, compared to bank rates in Western countries, like, I completely see why a lot of people, like, in the Western world especially, are just going for this. Because even on a bad day, you emerge, like, in a better position than, like, what a lot of bank rates would give you.
So, keeping with the tenor of the government, should we say, Crypto Ki Jai!
Oh. Ravi Shastri Zindabad. Ravi Shastri Zindabad.
Got it, brother. I don't know, you're younger than me. I don't know if you've ever seen those vicious people at Wankhede. Because you never attack the homeboy in any sport.
Of course.
Nobody
of
attacks
course.
The homeboy, you know? And the North Stand that especially would just go after him for no reason.
North Stand is brutal.
Just, because he was just good looking, you know? He was 6'3 and well built and you looked like a 70s film.
Like, star. How dare you?
How dare you be good looking? Look at us. I should have joined them then. I didn't think about it. All right, we're taking a quick break, which is 9 seconds long, and we bring in Silvery, a crypto producer and fan, and one of the big enthusiasts. IBM is filled, this factory that you're working with right now, with lovers of crypto, as you'll probably find out.
Yeah,
so let's
full
bring
on,
him in.
Full on.
He's only 9 years old, and the
hey
magic
guys.
Flute,
good
Mozart's
morning.
Opera is
What's
in
up,
the
man?
Background, which
good
means
morning.
My father's phone is on, but I don't know how to shut it. I'll cut it while you all talk.
Man, if Rohan thinks that everyone around him is 5 steps ahead of him, they are like 105 steps ahead of me. My understanding of it is very limited.
But you've invested money, bro. Which
I mean, I have. Player. I have, but I'm also like a herd mentality. I get so sold into what other people
don't
are doing very easily.
Also, you're Kashyap's friend, which means you must be getting sold a lot. Like,
yeah, that's basically it. Yeah, correct.
In the same way that basically like as Tanmay's friend, like it's just like the enthusiasm just gets to you. It's very irritating.
Exactly. Man, but it's right
but,
now it's going good, yeah.
Right but you,
now,
yeah. You had that dip, right, with the Elon Musk tweet shit and all, and then you came back, right? So how long did it take to rectify the max?
I just held on to whatever I had. I didn't invest much more during that time. It took like what, a month and a half or something?
It took about a month and a half too.
Yeah. But that's not bad at all, brother. I mean, any other thing, you won't recover in 6 weeks. That's pretty good.
Yeah, do you, Antiksh, do you also now do the thing because the market is good every morning, just once you open the app and just see it, and you're like,
Then
you go about your day. Like every few hours, just once, you're like, and just go back to the day. It's great.
And then sometimes towards the end of the day, it starts going red from green. Then I stop checking.
Then I just stop checking.
But hopefully that's during drinking hours. So you can quickly start.
Full on.
Recover again in the morning. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So how much money have you made, Ron, you said? Totally? 20% in percentile, but money, actuals?
I refuse to say. Or an open this thing. I refuse.
I can't
do 20%. I made 14 rupees. For I made 14 minute, entire rupees.
Per minute.
You could have just used Google Pay and you'd have gotten that the same amount.
I know, man. Those scratch cards are not what they used to be. Okay. The ROI on those scratch cards has gone down.
Is there any Indian crypto millionaire already? Like who's just made an absolute huge fortune?
Oh, I'm sure there are several, in fact. Why? Like just one. I'm sure there are several. Because I know that this is the sort of... I'm sure it's not public or whatever, but I feel like if you throw a dart among any like sort of tech startup or fintech startup in that direction, like founder type direction, I feel like you'll find at least a couple of like crypto millionaires or at least like, yeah, a couple of crypto lakh hairs. Like for sure, in my opinion.
Fidelity, the company that owns this, 100%. I'll double check everything. I'll talk to the people.
I'm sure. Like a lot of people at IBM are like in.
So, and the other big fear, I we shouldn't keep talking about this. I want to discuss other things. But the other big fear everybody has, again, people like me who know very little, is that when will this whole thing? We're just waiting for this whole thing to burst. You know, it's like it's too good to be true, et cetera.
But that's the fun of it, Cyrus. It bursts 6 times a year. That's the fun of it. It bursts 6 times a year. It's great.
It's here to stay for you. You don't believe that this whole thing will just disappear, become illegal. Governments of so-called democratic governments, of which one day maybe we'll see one, will put a span.
At this point, I don't see it like in the sense like just vanishing overnight. That's not a thing that I see at all. I feel like in the next 5 years, one way or another, its future will be decided. Like, I feel like in 5 years from now, we'll know whether this is something that's here to stay or something that we sort of look back on and go, that was a weird but interesting time. But we'll see.
What do you think will go first, my career or crypto? Let me put it that way and be nice.
I'll be nice. I think what will go is Elon Musk's relevance on the crypto market. No, that is the first thing that will win. Answer. That is the first thing that
those,
will win.
Cyrus, one second.
I think your career is going nowhere because I legit at this, like you could call it what you want. Like I have, like it's weird to me to go from obviously like you're a neighbor. I've seen you. But like as a kid, like going into like I'm getting like into 80s, deep 80s territory here. All right. I remember going to a theater as a kid to watch a movie. And there was an ad for, and this is how old is it? There was an ad for Fountain Pepsi. 91.
Fountain Pepsi.
And I'm like, holy crap, budgets that's were, the guy who lives in my lane. What are you saying?
Budgets were very low. Yeah, I also did Chota Pepsi, which got a lot of double meaning in it.
91 to 2021 now. It's 30 years. Like the longevity, I think, speaks for itself now. So, chill. Yes. I feel like you're gonna be around longer than crypto.
I am the LK1, but I'm not as funny as him though. I've actually got to tell you, he's hilarious. But he was still there. All right. Getting back to crypto.
One thing interesting though, Rohan, that you'll find very interesting. So right now, our main YouTube channel has been taken down off YouTube. I don't know if you noticed.
Yes, I am aware of this. What the hell?
Because I had a ransomware crypto attack on my computer. And they got all this information from me. So all my files were encrypted on my computer. And because my account was connected to the YouTube account as a manager, they got a hold of the YouTube credentials. This is what our understanding is. Yeah. But isn't that crazy that we are doing a show about crypto and I got a crypto scam also?
We don't know if we did it deliberately.
That's wild.
It's all under investigation at the moment.
That's crazy. Congratulations. That's amazing. Yeah, never again. Or a choti si bhool.
Yeah. So yesterday's John Oliver's Last Week Tonight's episode was about ransomware. And I was like, oh dude, he's making now episodes about my life. This is great. Like immediately something happens to me. Yeah.
He did one on failure in democracy about 2 weeks ago. That's your life.
Oh, I missed that one. Sorry.
Yeah.
All right.
So, do you have a question on? But any, I'm sure you'll be able to ask him on his main show. But do you have anything else for the Aam Aadmi? Because I think that's what the show is all about.
Yes. Yes. We have
the doubts, the myths.
Yes, we have a lot of AMA questions for Rohan. The first one is for Cyrus and Rohan. Pranjal Ojha asks, do you guys think Vipul Goyal is like Bill Hicks of Indian comedy?
I don't know if Vipul is like Bill Hicks. Vipul is very, very funny.
Well,
I
think.
No. So I'll tell you right now. Vipul Goyal is a very, very funny comic. Again, he's like an OG. Been around for ages. He's hilarious. But I think Bill Hicks was different, like sort of from what Vipul does. Like, I don't know if like I would say Vipul and like Bill Hicks, like, and it's not like a this or this thing. I just feel like in terms of what they do, they're very different. So I think Vipul Goyal is hilarious. But like Bill Hicks analogy, I'm not so sure about.
Also, Goyal is a Marwari name and Hicks as well, you know, supposed to be redneck from the middle of nowhere in America. So I don't think they probably, their worlds would collide. I think they'll stay far away from each other. Now, having said that, who's funnier, Vipul Goyal or Bill Hicks?
I think they're both very funny. I think Bill Hicks is angrier. Hey, man, I'm not going to like, I'm going to shit talk like my friends, man.
Respect more. It's a really stupid question they ask people, who do you like more? Because you know,
yeah,
it's
really
unnecessary,
like,
sometimes. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, it's just like, why?
It's so unnecessary. Is Virat better than Sachin? I'm like, it's an unnecessary question.
It just adds nothing to the debate.
It's like asking Cyrus, who would he prefer, Elvis or the Beatles? And he's like, oh my God, I don't know at all.
I gave him a firing yesterday, Amit Doshi.
Yeah, Amit, yeah, you're like,
poking the bear to get an answer. I'm like, you know, Afghanistan is in flames. And this is the only question you could come up with. You know, people are hanging onto planes out of desperation. What a horrible sight that is, man.
Really. It's quite something. It's really quite something.
Can you believe how important the world is? We just sit around, we can't do anything. I mean, it's clearly, I mean...
It's just, it's like, I've seen some of the images that have just been, and like my brain is physically not computing some of them. Like, where if some of those images I'd seen in a movie also, I'd be like, what is happening? Like, what is happening? But I mean, it beggars belief.
And if you write about villains and this and that, I mean, the cruelty, of course, not just from the Taliban, just this sense of desperation of people who've lost all hope. And what could be worse than that? Losing all hope.
Who've lost like worse than so death. Much, right? As a result of...
Really?
Like what's been happening, like so much.
You know, I think we should send the big guns to Afghanistan to teach Taliban a lesson. You know, the Rakhi Sawans, you know, the KRKs. But I think they'll turn it around. The Taliban would leave. 15 minutes of subculture from India, and I think we can hammer it in. To go back to the cave and leave other people alone. It's just unbelievable. And you see them walking around with the machine guns and talking about democracy. I don't know if you all saw those bits where their spokesperson in Doha is talking about democracy, not democracy, but in the sense that no one...
I mean, just safe. Government.
Yeah, the government will look after everyone. No, nothing to fear, nothing to worry about. And then they cut to what's happening in Kabul. They're walking around like mafia, you know, with their strange uniforms and their gun-toting. And
pretty much exactly that.
It kind of looks like... So I read a headline yesterday, look at this Taliban Taliban militant just chilling at the president of Afghanistan's bungalow or something like that. Okay, yeah, so I'm like thinking, like, dude, this is like TMZ coverage. These guys are like just trying to paparazzi terrorists.
So they enter the palace and they don't know what to do. It's a bit like those the attack on the Senate that happened on the Congress rather in America, where they start taking pictures and selfies and all that. So they enter the place, they sit on the desk, but they don't know what to do. They've never been in a proper official
If you want a more complete picture of just how absurd this dystopia is, today somebody sent me a video of, they also managed to get into a theme park. And there's just these video of just this group of Taliban on bumper cars, like just playing bumper cars. And I'm looking at it and I'm like, just how absurd is this dystopia? Yeah. Like how just...
So they're having a good time and in between they're going like, get to America! Come on!
And then just talking and I'm like, what? Just how these, like, of all the images you can imagine to come out of, like, it's just, like, we live in just the most spectacular dystopia.
But would
like,
they do normal things? Would they be ordering pizza and all once life resumes? I mean, just think, hello, the Taliban and sons, hello. I would like thin crust, no artichokes, no pickle, no onions. I was just thinking, how will they, it's not going to happen, right? Life is just changing.
What is even the definition of a normal life in a country like this anymore, right? Like, what is just... Today, if your people physically hanging from planes as they're taking off, I feel like your entire definition of normal shifts pretty fucking far.
And no one is asking the mean questions, which some people will find insensitive, but I don't think it is. You're worried about women who will be sent back in or into their caves or, you know, mistreated. What happens to all the other genders that are fighting for equality across the Western world? What about them? What if you're a transgender person in Afghanistan? Can you imagine?
I mean, I think it's as simple as if you are not a sort of cishet Talibani man, anybody but that is in trouble, right? Essentially. And what are you going to... It's just... It's one of those things where it's going to sound so horrible, but it's like I want to... I don't know if I have the moral fiber to sit and contemplate the true horror of it, if that makes any sense. Like, I almost don't want to contemplate because I don't know if I do. Like,
me and the wife put the telly off. We only do that during Arnab and Big Boss. I mean, honestly, we just couldn't take it. You can't watch it. Because it's real, right? If it's fiction, it's fine. But this is now... Art has gone out of the window and reality is so much worse. And like I said, just the sense of loss of hope. I mean, how can you hang on to a plane? Who does that? What kind of rational person would ever do that? That is a better option than going back from the airport. Imagine the thought process in that person's mind.
That it's this or death, and that just makes... And it, anyway, on that cheerful
note. Three
comedians
have depressed everybody for the last 10 minutes. This is what we do. That's what we're here for. And then we'll have some levity, of course, thanks to Silvery's AMAs, which will be about the Lord's Test match, I hope.
There are some questions about that, so we'll get to that.
Cyrus, just raise your mic.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And you may hear this voice, Rishi, in the background saying, raise your voice. This is not God.
Raise the mic.
I want to do it after I contemplate why he's asking me these mean questions. People will be wondering who that voice is in the background. We're talking about the Taliban and all that. They're worried about, you know, Big Brother, people listening to everything we're saying. Rishi with an H is a lovely guy. But he has no political aspirations at the moment. We don't know anything about him. He's just a very nice tech fellow who watches a lot of adult content and for some reason has landed up in IBM. Does he get a salary, Silvery?
My theory is that nothing in Indian audio can happen without... let me rephrase that. My theory is that you can't do anything in Indian audio without at least one person named Rishi involved. Like, it is a requirement. I have realized this.
This law would be post-2014 or pre... 2014.
This law is... It is called the Rishi K law, and it is the Rishi K law of Indian
Rishi
audio.
As in the Swami Rishi, and hence
I'm going. This is the Rishi K law of Indian comedy.
Yeah. Yes. The unknown soldier of Radio Midday, is it, or Radio One, whatever it's called right now, Rishi K.
Radio at large, like.
Don't say at large and things like that because he's huge now. But let me tell you, when he first came into a booth, he was hardly 60 kilos, and you know, I mean, he's really blossomed. And you talk about longevity. He's been there from the 80s, by the way.
Yeah, he has. Exactly.
Why is no action taken against him? You're after me. He's 40 years in the business, my son. 40 years.
Yep.
All right.
All right, next one.
Ron, you'll be 20, 25 yourself.
Yeah, I am. I'm sprightly 19.
19 years in the business. Silvery?
Yeah.
I am 14. Okay, sure, yeah.
How are you 14? You're 28. What are you in a
circus? So you know, then why do you ask?
No, I just want to know when
you went how many years in the business?
Years in the business? Oh, okay. I thought you were asking age. In podcasting, I'm like two.
No, no, your first
and
comedy
half years.
Show was when?
Oh, 2018 was my 2018 January. Was my
just
first.
3 years.
Yeah, very, very.
Damn.
You're still nursing. Yeah. You're still
but a brave in the woods.
Oh. Yeah. Really? Don't talk to us. Oh, can't believe it. Kid like that. Okay, next one. Sorry,
you have to lower your mic a little bit now.
Oh, man.
You're bleeding into the mic. No, not off. That's again too low. Yeah, this is good.
I want Rishi to come here and hold my mic. I mean nothing by that.
The entire episode.
Yeah, right. He just stands there.
Next one comes in from Wannabe Vegan. He or she says, Rohan, your social media presence is a breath of fresh air. AMA question for all of you. What are you reading currently?
Well, the question, Rohan, your social media presence is a breath of fresh air. That's exactly what we're all reading at the moment. but a more intellectual answer awaits us. Yes, Rohan, what are you reading?
I just finished a really fun sort of sci-fi young adult. And I know I'm not a young adult, but sci-fi YA series called the Red Rising series. It was very entertaining, very gripping, and very fun to read. Now what I'm reading, though, because of my friend Samay Raina's chess streams, is I'm currently reading Chess Openings. Yes, I'm a thrilling person. I'm a thrilling person, guys.
I challenge you to a match then, since you've decided you're the nerd of the year.
No, I have literally just. You play what?
Sicilian defense. I've mastered it.
What are you saying?
Yes, sir.
What are you saying?
You can say anything on the podcast. It doesn't really matter. Bobby Fischer.
That's true. That's true. That's like, yeah.
Kasparov. Straight up. Kasparov. Anand, nothing.
Karo Khan defense.
This new kid, Mr. Gujarati. I can't even remember his first name. Very talented boy. Yeah.
Yes.
Beat him. I beat him left-handed. Two hands behind my back. So easy, man.
Did you use one? Did you use one dice or two?
One die. One dice or two die.
One die.
My family, Rohan, I don't know if you guys used to do this, but we used to have this from my father and me and now my son and me and all that. We used to continue with the game. So the game would be kept, like, you know, it takes a long time to play.
So like
chess.
Over days, basically.
Yeah, yeah. And that's the whole amazing thing is, people would walk around that board, you know, double checking whether it's been moved in the interim. Because say you're playing in the evening of every day or whatever, and then the whole day, whoever's at home or whatever, it was hilarious. And then the arguments about whether a piece has been moved. But we took it very seriously.
Oh, that's amazing.
And the same temperamental issues which a lot of people have in the world is when you lose at chess, you really feel like an ass and get upset.
Yeah, you do. You feel stupid. You feel stupid.
Three generations of poachers misbehave when they lose. Kicking, shouting, screaming.
That's amazing though. Okay, yeah. when I'm a little better, we shall play. I shall knock at your door. Confrontation.
But then you'll just humiliate me because of my age. You know, because I can't see anything. I'll be colorblind. I won't even know what's white and black.
But your age is better, no? You were around when the Sicilian defense was invented. That's like important.
That's
like,
true.
You have context.
I was part of it.
Exactly. You were the Sicilian. You're the Sicilian.
Okay. Why do we go to chess? Why did that come up?
What are you reading? It came from
what are you reading?
That's where.
Silvery, what are you reading? Kashmiri versus Afghani. Which one is better and why?
Afghanis are way better. I mean, they go to they like bumper cars and all, like good times.
Hey, poor guys. Don't blame the Afghan people. No. Okay? These are some strange fellows with a philosophy of monstrosity itself. Yeah. God. Amazing.
So right now I'm reading.
They don't pay for the bumper cars. It's just a small tidbit. Yeah. No. Oh, and by the way, they went straight to the prison to release all the prisoners. That was their first act of egalitarianism, which I salute and applaud. So the worst criminals, including the worst terrorists who were locked up, were free within 5 minutes. Oh. All right, back to depression. Question?
I was talking about what I'm reading right now. I'm reading two anime mangas. One of them is One Piece, which again, I've been reading for like the last 10 years. Weekly, and the next one is My Hero Academia, or in Japanese it's Boku no Hero Academia. But
nice.
I like that shit.
So you're a big anime guy, aren't you?
I love anime, yes. Huge anime fan. But I like a lot of things. Like I like anime, I like comedy a lot. I like that's what the two things I like.
I just like I've just caught up. Like I've not finished the manga, but I've just caught up with Attack on Titan, like the anime.
Oh man, so much fun. Too great.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Epic.
How do you have time to do that when you're playing chess and reading about chess? And chess is the one game you can sort of read and get better.
I'm a true multi-thinker. Yeah. Like I'm playing chess on one side, watching anime. No, I'm not. This is why I lose at chess.
You're probably the greatest human being I've ever met in my life.
He's reading about chess.
You know, everybody says that. Everybody says that, you know.
So many people can't be wrong.
This is true.
Elvis Presley record. 10 million people can't be wrong. That was the name of
the record. Yeah.
There you go. Okay, I'm calling him out. What's next?
Yeah, all right. The next one comes from Daneshwar Sharma. He says, question for Cyrus and Rohan. Does being a comic teach you to be a minimalist? A joke has to be as precise as possible.
In theory of comedy,
it teaches you to occasionally be economical, yes, but there are also a lot of jokes that turn on the fact that they're extremely verbose and then flip on something extremely simple. So I feel like it teaches you, it puts more than one tool in your like sort of toolbox. It can teach you to be economical sometimes, and then sometimes just teach you, like Cyrus, we were talking about before this thing happened, a lot of it can just be talking to your audience for an extended period of time to like sort of mine something from there.
Yeah, but I think I understand what he's saying. It's also sometimes you have to fit it like a tailor suit does a suit. You know, you got to fit it for that. So when you're fitting it for that, they give you 20 minutes. You are going to look at trying to get your 10 gags in the 20 minutes, and hence you cut down. You do the same show, and it could be 35 minutes, but you allow yourself to be more verbose and perhaps have more fun of the joke. Sometimes just get on with it.
It definitely teaches you the art of editing. Like,
if I'm telling my wife a joke, I make it really short because she just gets angry really fast. But if I'm telling my mom a joke, I can really play with it for some time because she believes I'm really good. Great thing about mothers, they actually think you're talented.
It's great.
Amazing? Yeah. My son, great. I'm like, wow. Mothers across the world, fooled.
So being a comic really teaches you is you should have an audience of mothers.
Mothers have never said bad things about your show. I've got to tell you. Yeah. And if anybody says bad things about your show, mothers are the first to attack the critic. Isn't that glorious?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. These people just have time and all.
Why is your son dressed like a peacock? Well, at least he has work. There's no need. There's no comeback for peacock. Let it go.
Just very funny ad though, Cyrus. Cyrus, hilarious ad. Huh? That was a very funny ad with Pratik Babbar.
It's a funny ad, but it's also a little bit of like my daughter and all, like, Dad, why? I have to go back to people, like, and they're all making fun in the chat and all that. Your father's a peacock. I'm like, yeah, well, you know, that's what I got now. You know,
but that's hilarious. Like,
you don't get to be the Pepsi model. Sometimes you have to be the peacock. You just, you know, what do they say? There's no bad roles, small roles, big roles. They're just roles. You got to do it. Of course, Rohan will now laugh for 5 minutes. I would have never done that. I have my standards.
No, I will be sad because nobody would even ask me to be the peacock. That's the sad thing. Like,
you don't even want to be the peacock. You can't even see the guy. It's silly. Yeah. All right.
Next one. Next one comes from Kashin Shetty. He says, "Hey Rohan, I have rewatched AIB's video Every Party Song more than 100 times. Could you tell us how the shooting experience was and how it was to shoot with Irfan Khan?"
It was, and this is not like just the politically correct answer, it was an amazing experience. Irfan was the humblest person. Like, we were shooting on, I think our budget was maybe like 100th. Like, it's important to remember that when we were shooting this with him, he was shooting Jurassic Park. Okay.
Wow.
Like, please, it's very important to remember that at the same time he was shooting Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
Or Jurassic World or whatever that one was called. And then he came and he did this with us. We didn't have like even money for like a dressing room for him or whatever. When we shot that pool stuff, he literally went, like, put a mat out on like one corner of the floor of one of the rooms of that bungalow and like took an afternoon nap and then came back and worked. It was like, what an experience. Like, getting goosebumps again just thinking about it. It was a too good experience, like, working with him. Guy was a legend in every way.
Yeah, absolutely.
Alrighty, next one.
Next one comes in from Ruben David. AMA for Cyrus, he says, "For a change, did India initiate the aggression bouncing Jimmy Anderson in the first England innings?" Yeah.
That's a great question because I thought it was overdone. Honestly, I thought it was unnecessary. Why is he bouncing Jimmy Anderson 11, 15 times? You know, once or twice, fine. You hit him about 4 or 5 times and then it seemed a little personal. But apparently, there's an inside story. There's some sledging that's been going on from Jimmy's side. And so Bumrah was, you know, so if you want to, the aggressor was initially Jimmy. Okay, this is our Indian version, but maybe it's not fully correct. But Jimmy starts it. This guy then gets the ball in his hand, starts giving it to him, then overdoes it. And then Jimmy actually came out with a lot of anger in his first spell. We didn't get any wickets. And but still, the run of play was with England. It was all the way with England till the first half of yesterday. And then it just changed. It's a great thing about cricket. I love cricket. Cricket is better than romance now for me, honestly. Because so many girls that I've asked out and they've said no. And then finally one girl said maybe, which meant no. But, you know, she didn't want to be mean to me. And that was such a big moment. Rohan, have you ever been through that? Those 32 rejections and then a possible maybe.
I've never had anybody say maybe. I've never had anybody say maybe. Like, I'm still waiting.
I wish you had that feeling, that hope.
I'm still waiting. One day. When that crypto investment finally goes fully up, no. That time the world will
see. Let me play the right music. Hum honge kamyab ek din. How did you like that? I love the head shake.
Ravi Shastri Zindabad.
And don't you forget that this generation doesn't know anything about the pain he suffered, in spite of being the most utilitarian, in a sense, of all cricketers.
Second part of his question is, was the revenge strategy to bounce Bumrah and Shami the reason England lost?
No, so there's a little bit of chance in cricket. In the initial bit, the ball didn't go to a fielder. There were lots of miscued shots. I think Bumrah was batting badly in the beginning because he was trying to attack them with, you know, adrenaline and aggression. Then they cooled down and the second half of that partnership was something else. And then Shami started batting like Vengsagar at Lords. I mean, it was just going from the middle of the bat, mid-wicket, straight drive, the hit over the long on of the spinner for 6. So suddenly he started looking like a fabulous... But whatever you say, this Indian team, and that's why I want to come back to Ravi Shastri. Ravi had this, you know, bounce. Positivity that the others didn't have, and always was in the free. He was like an Aussie with a accent from Shivaji Park or Matunga, really. But he was very Aussie in his demeanor. He's put that Aussie demeanor into the Indian boys, Virat and all. And for the first time, the most aggressive cricketers, I would dare say this, the most aggressive cricketers in the world are Indians. I mean, not if you can pick up the Hindi and, you know, whatever other languages we speak on the field, we're always making sarcastic comments about them, you know, which is passive-aggressive at the very least. And then, of course, there's in-your-face and the Bumrah incident, etc., etc. So I think we have really come out guns blazing in the last 3 or 4 years. red ball cricket especially. I think white ball cricket is closer between the countries. But red ball cricket, look at this. I mean, I'm very happy. I just think this is a great thing. Like life, you can be up, you can be down. And things change. Growing up in the 80s, as he keeps reminding me, we nearly lost everything. And we just, you know, Gavaskar defending and trying to save the match.
Oh, man.
Arthush, a little bit here, Jimmy Amanon. But they're all said and done. We were always on the back foot. And now, England is looking like a team. I honestly think if we get 5 days in sunshine, they will lose every of the three test matches to come. Okay, they have no batting except Joe Root. And they're psychologically damaged. And now we've got these two superstar all-rounders at 9 and 10. Brother, can you imagine? Talk about cryptocurrency. Yeah. We've got it. We've got our cryptocurrency sporting. And of course, Olympics are forgotten. No one will remember those six single finalists and the bronze medal in the hockey team because we won a large test match. So that's that. India? Oh, that's done. Next one. Next one is... Rohan, are you okay to stay on for 5 minutes or you want to go?
Yeah, I can do 5 minutes. Yeah, I know. I can do five minutes. Great. No problem.
Next one is another cricket one. Comes in from Girish Patel. He says, what is the reason we miss so many slip catches?
You're asking me like I played 400 test matches.
Yeah, I mean, it can be anything. Yeah.
No, but there are a couple of things anyone can see, which is hard hands, even the most professional cricketers. If you grab at the ball, if your hands are hard, it's always difficult to stick. You have to keep soft hands. You know, I learned this from a young age because my parents made me fetch. They wanted a dog. They got a baby instead. So they treated me like one and they would make me fetch a ball. Yeah, fair trade. A mistake, actually, because once he got the dog, the things were so much better in my family. Which reminds me, your sister Renuka, the record is abysmal in lockdown. The dog, Obi, has been walked once by your brother-in-law and once by her. Her at 5 in the morning, by mistake one day, I suddenly see her because nobody comes out at 5 except me. And I suddenly see her and she was appalled that someone was down because I don't think she brushed her hair and all. You know, there's a women get, you know, that somebody, she didn't expect to see anyone but the watchman, not knowing that I'm almost the watchman. So, you know, it's the same thing. But horrible record, 2 years. This is what I hate about Mulbile. Please take it up with them. Obi,
I will take it up with them, yes.
Who looks after Obi? Why couldn't they walk their own dogs when they're sitting at home?
I will take this up with them.
It gives us such a bad name as we care about no one and nothing and don't want to do the extra mile for anybody. What the hell is wrong with society? Coming back to the Taliban.
I will ask them to fix society at once.
And why doesn't she come to the club? Why she stopped coming to the club? Is she one of the scary weddies or she's moved on to something else? A lot of people have changed.
No, I think she's just had a lot of work.
Yeah. Also, timings have shifted. Have you noticed that? This stupid.
Yeah, lockdown. Lots of people timing.
Nobody's
yeah.
getting up. Those who have, you know, shifted their timings. They just can't get up and come.
Yeah. All that 6 a.m. stuff isn't happening anymore.
Yeah, 6. 4:45, Ron, I'll call you. We'll chat crypto.
This is why my phone is on DND. This is why.
My phone doesn't have any Wi-Fi. It never works. Don't worry about it. We can never get in touch. So if it's an emergency, Dr. Vijay Mallya and me are the two people you don't call. All right. One last one.
All right. Last one comes from Bruce Wayne. I want to see how you guys answer this. So... he says, if opposites attract each other, why does the negatively charged electron not ultimately fall into the positively charged nucleus?
Oh, the size. Size is the issue. This is just philosophy. Philosophy doesn't explain the specifics. Specifics are outdated sometimes and don't match with philosophy. So you've got to understand that it's very easy to just philosophize and give you one blanket statement like all clouds are blue or gray. You know, but that's not the specifics because sometimes at a certain condensation point, it's actually green, the cloud, which people don't know. And then it turns from that green to a shimmering white to gray and then to a black cloud. So
you're saying every electron is different.
But he's a scientist. He's an MBA from Chennai who's also a scientist. Ron has a very
also, the thing is, see, a lot of people don't understand that relationships are complicated. People are not just one thing. You know, so sometimes things attract, sometimes like they repel. It happens. And, you know, I think as we all know, the correct answer to this is yoga. And that is my answer.
Yoga in leotards. I feel that Indians wear the wrong garments for yoga. Ron, have you noticed that? You can't wear trousers and black shoes and do yoga. You just look stupid. But they still do
it's
that.
True.
You know, garib aadmi hai, uske paas sporting outfit nahi hai, toh aisa baat kyun karta hai? Don't be an elitist. No, it's not an elitist. Dress for what you're doing. That's why I appreciate Indian beggars. Have you ever seen an Indian beggar wearing a suit? Well, in Malwahil, yes. But other than that, have you ever seen? No. They always dress for their work. And we must appreciate that. Really. Podcasters around the world now dress elegantly for podcasts. I'm wearing a
shirt. Only on the top half. Only on top half. Top half. Top half.
I've got pants on today because I'm in an office. You don't have pants.
I'm just going to take your word for it.
Can we see your cryptocurrency? Can you show us your crypto, bro?
This is that sort of party now.
Oh man, so you're going for training or something? You're going for your workout?
You look. I went for a walk in the morning. I went for a walk in the morning.
But why are you wearing a, like, overall this, what do you call this, a track top?
Oh, I'm not in Mumbai right now. I'm in Uttarakhand in the hills, and I'm like fully enjoying at like 7,000 feet, fully enjoying life.
Uttarakhand.
I'm working and chilling here.
You went for the Kumbh Mela and stayed back.
I just decided why not, you know. I mean, it was just such a spiritual experience that I figured why not.
Isn't that, I know we have to end now, isn't that one of the great pieces of comedy for you in the last 2 years, that really was not a big deal for the government? I mean, they're telling me to go back into my building in Malwa Hill, wear my mask because I'm going to spread it, but you know, 40,000 people can bathe together wearing nothing, and that's fine. And
during the peak of COVID,
of course. Now, I mean, how are you gonna interrupt a good party, right? No fun breaking up a party.
And as usual, this is typical of South Bombay parties, no chicks, right?
Exactly. Yeah, so there you go.
All heterosexual men, by the way, this is by choice, they don't have girls there, but they like girls by their nature. Oh, ouch. Anyway, thanks, Rohan. This has been an eye-opener, even though yours is shutting. I'm sure you've got lots of interesting things to do.
I lost you guys there for a second.
We're just saying Bible praising you, so I can't do that again.
No. But, I would never put you through that.
But no. Come on. We have the old footage. We'll just play that. Lots of nice things. Listen, I'm a big, what's the word? When you're regionalist, I'm a big South Mumbai guy, you know, because I basically have a real minority, as you know, when you started this journey of greatness in this comedy industry. So there's nobody, how many of us are from our side of town, you know? So we have to stick together. I got like Sunil Shetty, Akshay Khanna, you, me, Simi Garewal. We have five. We can never break this bond.
This is the op. We finally have the answer to the question: what is the opposite of the Avengers?
The five find-outers. That's what we are. Wow.
It's just that's right there. Just Simi Garewal, Cyrus Brocha, Rohan Joshi, Akshay Khanna, and Sunil Shetty standing against the forces of evil.
If we are to be Gariboka Avengers, let's since we are the two of the year, let's pick the role that we are taking. Can I be Hulk? I want to be Hulk because I don't like clothes.
You can totally be Hulk. I have decided I will be Hawkeye because he's always up in his house only and he's shooting from there. So if I cannot leave my home and still show up for work, that would be great.
Now we got to give three more roles as we end this podcast. So what do we give Anna? Sunil Shetty, who everybody loves. Nobody says a bad word about
him. I think Sunil Shetty is Tony Stark. Like, given that, like, he's aging like fine wine, I think he is the Tony Stark.
You're a bastard. Fair enough. Okay. And the character, let's not end the film here. Okay, that's so we're left with who? Simi Garewal and Akshay Khanna.
It's a Thor.
You got Thor. Akshay Khanna can be Captain Malabarin. He can be Captain Malabarin. And Simi Garewal. There we go.
For Captain America or Malabar Hill or whatever you want, Simi should be Thor. I feel
fair. Yeah.
The skin.
Fair. Yeah.
That Norwegian sort of look about. You know. I think I'll go with that. Are we done? Is that a fair assessment?
I think that's fair assessment. I think we've nailed it. We've got it.
We'll give the podcast salute.
Malabar Hill shall be safe.
See you guys. Podcast salute. Yes. There you go.
See you. All adults here.
Having played Avengers with people who have never offended us in any way in our entire life.
In any way, shape, or form.
The nicest people in the world. Who's the Taliban now, Mr. Rohan Bloody Joshi? Who's the Taliban now? Yeah. All right. Okay. So the last word on cryptocurrency is with Rohan Joshi. Tune in. The show is called
A Show About Crypto.
Alzheimer's. A Show About Crypto with Rohan and Silvery. We'll see everybody soon. It's bye-bye. I'll just do a quick wipe so that it looks professional.
Okay. That was some smooth. What editing software did you use for that?
Hi. It's from the 80s.